What is up, everyone? We are back with another New World video. Today, we're going to be talking about farming gypsum attunement potion materials. And this isn't a single region that contains all of the materials. It is so dense that if you are lucky, you can get enough materials in one run in order to make 7 potions for the whole week or for 1,000 motes. And 4,000 motes is 4,000 coin per hour, depending on your server. So if you do want coin or you do need to farm these attunement potion materials, then this farm is for you. But before I get into that, my name is Kaezox, and I created this channel in order to donate a portion of revenue gain to nonprofit organizations that help out disabled veterans like myself. And by watching, you are contributing, so I thank each and every one of you. This farm is in Eden Grove. I first start off at the Last Stand outpost and then you head on west. We pick up all the life moths until we reach the river and then we get all the spinefish north until we go to the shrine. When you reach the shrine, you can go northwest towards the Soulwyrm farm and hit up this area and then hit up this area on the south. After that, run downhill and pick up the spinefish. Along the way, there may be some gleamites and floating presents, so be sure to pick those up as well. Now go northeast grabbing spinefish and blightmoths. After this, you're going to have a few choices. You can either go up and gather spinefish and go in a circle to keep gathering again, or you can keep going on east to pick up the last floating spinefish and then go back up north to grab these 4 life moths again, as they're already going to be spawned during this run. After that, head on down south and start grabbing the Earthshell turtles. Follow along this path, and when you reach this corner, we go to the shrine and fast travel to this other shrine. You can also choose to walk, but since Azoth is extremely cheap now because of the aptitude chests, we opt to fast travel instead. Finally, we head on over to the Lightning Beetle farm. Just follow this path until you reach this intersection. You will need to put a campfire here because these enemies swarm you, and just in case you die, you will respawn here. It is also close enough that if you die in these next two areas, you will reach this spawn point. So go on east to pick up these 3 lightning beetles and then run on west. Here is a little tricky because there's one stuck inside an ice cave. If you can ninja grab it, that is good, but usually I do have to kill these enemies nearby. The last one in this section is right outside of the area. After this lightning beetles, we finally hit the salamander snails farm. You run across the rocks and then head on southeast picking up 8 more. If you are unlucky enough with the salamander snail drops, you can also head on into Weaver's Fen following this trail to pick up an additional 12 salamander snails. Now that's the farm. If you only wanted the run details, then here you go, but if you also wanted a full run to have something play in the background while you're running the farm, well, that is the next part of the video. It will also have some timestamps in the video progress bar so you can skip through certain areas that you have trouble with. In my experience, this is hardly ever farmed, but this farm is purely picking up these high tiered gatherables, and sometimes you will get attunement potion materials and other times you will get 35 plus motes each. If you want to get those rare drops for those attunement potions, then equip harvesting luck gear, but if you do want some coin and need those low tiered motes, then do not use harvesting gear, but use proficiency boosters to boost the amount gained each node. With that being said, here is the full run, so enjoy it, and if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button and consider subscribing as it greatly helps me donate even more to disabled veterans. Thank you all for tuning in and listening, and until next time. Thank you.
Thank you. No,